left me to introduce our speaker tonight. It is our very own Priscilla T. Graham. And Priscilla is a Georgia native and a Gulf War veteran. Credits her success to God, family, and faith. She received a Bachelor's of Business Administration and Accounting from Texas Southern University in 1998 and a Master's degree in Business Administration from the University of Phoenix in December 2014. Let us give her a hand. I'm not finished with her after, so. After 6 years of service in the United States Army, is there anything you can do with this microphone? Okay, thank you, sir. Anyway, after 6 years of service in the United States Signal Corps and graduating from Texas Southern University, she embarked upon her current journey of changing lives that can change the world by providing opportunities and educational tools for young people to experience success. Priscilla's passion for servant leadership was born in 1994 at a juvenile justice conference in Austin, Texas, where Congresswoman Sheila Jackson Lee said, "Too often, when people need us the most, we give them ours." When I read her bio, I was like, that speaks volumes right there. Servant leadership affords Priscilla the opportunity to give her best to those who need it the most. Now, that's good enough for, on that bow she sent me. But what I want to let you know that I know Priscilla personally. We've been friends since elementary school. She, I, and Paula, and Marsha Law. Y'all remember Marsha? The four of us used to hang together. And I told Priscilla yesterday, we really were in a game. Because every year, we would go to the JCPenney catalog and order the same shoes. You already know that, but we did. And if you messed with one, you had to contend with all four of us. It's the way we roll like that. But Priscilla grown to be a very nice young lady. And I'm just so proud of her. Because the things that we used to do together was just like, woo. Anyway, that's between all of us, the four of us, the three of us, right? And so I just want to present to some and introduce to others Priscilla T. Now, let us give her a hand as she comes forward.
Well, Sherry, thank you for that great introduction. They said I could say whatever I want to say tonight, whatever God placed on my heart. Well, I tell you, I'm so happy that I came home to this 35th reunion. Woo-hoo. I've just had a ball. Everyone has been great. People I haven't seen for 35 years. Ms. McKent, I haven't seen her since 8th grade. So I was really excited when I saw her name on the list that she was going to be here, that Miss McKent is going to be here. Now, she said she treated like her brothers and sisters. I don't think Miss McKent treated like her brothers and sisters. You know Miss McKent, she was hard. She didn't take any stuff. And the only thing I remember about Miss McKent, I was telling someone, Miss McKent, I thought she was somebody. And I wanted to be somebody too, you know? But she was somebody, she was young, she was vibrant, and she knew her stuff. And so what a role model that we had to look up to when we were just 12 and 13 years old. Most definitely. Now, I was telling Miss Adams I had algebra in middle school. It took me a long time to get out of it, but I did get it. But I'm so blessed and I'm so happy I came home. If a lot of you don't know my story, what I've been doing the last 3 years is actually researching history of African Americans 150 years after slavery. And I've been in Houston, Texas, and I've been doing it in Texas. But my ultimate goal was to do it around the country, not just Texas. So I come home and guess where I find a wealth of history that we never even look at and we pass by every day. So I've just been so full of that. Let's give Lovetta Jones a hand because they have turned Dewey City into a historic district. There's so much history over there. And we just passed out who's at Douglas. Where's Lovetta? They have done great things over there. Things that I never knew. I never knew it was a hanging tree over in Dewey City. Never knew that. And when I first came by Douglas for the middle school, when I I saw the gym. I was like, oh, that's the gym we used to play in. And I saw the first brick building because I came in on the left side. I was like, what building was that? That was the band building. Could not remember that. I finally remembered it. But I just found out so much information. I'm just full. And I came in early. It's my first time ever coming in early. First time ever. And I did come to the event. I came to the event on Thursday. Yes. And I had a fabulous time. So I want to thank God for just embracing me. It was just like yesterday. Like, we just left school. It was like yesterday. But what I want to say to you, my message is to you, is that I wake up every day and I'm on fire. I have passion. I'm ready to go. I'm ready to go get going what I'm doing. And if you haven't found that passion yet, and you don't have that thing that drives you, that you just can't wait to do, as long as you wake up every day, you have an opportunity to do something great. You have an opportunity to be great. And I've always been a person about first. Number ones. But let me tell you, you don't have to be number one to be great. There's a whole lot of number twos that have done way more than one has done. So I'm saying you still have that opportunity. Don't let other people define you and tell you who you are. Don't have it. You have to teach your kids that. You have to instill that in them. Don't let other people define you. Just like today, they bullied me today. At the Y. Just because, you know, I have a lot of passion. And I like being in charge. That's just me. I like being in charge. And it's okay. Rosemary said, well, we're not afraid of you no more. But she would have gotten that line over it. Design you for the person that he has for you. If you don't do that, you'll never find out who the person is. And so it's such a joy when you do get on that path and you put God first in your life. I don't do anything. I've already tried that plan myself. Priscilla plan, I've tried that. I had to submit to God and go with God's plan. So whatever God has for me, I'm open to receive it. And I will go and do anything that he has for me to do. So people always ask me, what do I do? Whatever God says, I do. That's really it. So I can never put a definition on it because I've done so many things. And I have so many other things to do. So many other things to do. And I encourage you to find that fire. It's not too late. You might be 53, 54, 52, but we still can find that fire. You still get up and wake up every day that you can do something great in someone's life. If you don't tell your story, somebody else will tell your story, and they will write you out of your story. So if you don't know your story and your history, you really need to dig down and start passing that story down. Because the last person to know your name that dies, you cease to exist. Your history is no more. No one else will know about you. And having a good name, a good name without good deeds is just a good name. The people that do the good deeds are the ones that they're going to research and find many years down the road. Just like us, we all in this room remember Miss McKinnon, Miss Adams. Their name will go on because of their good deeds and what they've sown into us. So that's important. So I'm going to tell y'all a joke. Now, this lady told me, her name is Miss Doris. She said this man had his parent. And every day, and this man was married to his wife. The first wife was a nice looking lady, she's pretty late. Parent loved her. Second wife, she didn't look so good. So every time the parent go into the kitchen, the parent say, you ugly. Go back in the kitchen, he say, you ugly. So she go talk to her husband. She say, I'm tired of this parrot talking about our husband. We're gonna have to get rid of this parrot. So the man goes in the kitchen, talk to the parrot, say, if you keep calling my wife ugly, I'm gonna get rid of you. So Lane goes back in the kitchen again, and the parents say, "You know."